As testing clinics were once again overwhelmed, many Victorians started a new week with a sense of deja vu.
We have a hotel quarantine worker that has tested positive yesterday.
The authorised officer in her 50s was working at the Holiday Inn Airport Hotel in an admin role checking in guests. She tested negative at the end of her shift on Thursday, had 2 days off, and returned to work on Sunday where she developed symptoms and tested positive.
At this stage, again, it doesn't appear to be any breaches of infection prevention control procedures.
The woman visited three businesses while potentially infectious, including Maraschino's Cakes in Maidstone on Friday morning and Dan Murphy's in Sunshine in the evening. On Saturday afternoon, she went to Off Your Tree in Water Gardens before heading back to Dan Murphy's on Saturday night. Anyone who's been to those places should isolate and get tested.
We always take an abundance of caution on our approach, so we're working on a worst case scenario that says we're dealing with a complex strain. We do not know that yet.
More than 100 people, including dozens of police and ADF personnel, are now in isolation. The woman is the second hotel quarantine worker to catch the virus in a week after a 26-year-old floor monitor at the Grand Hyatt Tennis Hotel tested positive. From today, all hotel quarantine staff are being encouraged to get tested on their day off, but it won't become mandatory until at least the end of the week.
Don't forget, people on their days off, once you ask them to test, that becomes a work day. So this will be asking people to do pretty much 7 days a week.
They have to be paid. It's not only a reasonable thing to pay them, but it would be the law that they have to be paid.
Every Victorian who has been asked to go and get tested, who's waited in queues for hours and hours and hours, aren't getting paid.
The Victorian government has repeatedly claimed that our hotel quarantine system is the gold standard. But serious questions are being asked as to how the virus escaped again. It means the workforce will be put to the test. Around a third of the 3,000 quarantine workers are currently in isolation. But the government insists it has enough staff to deal with an increase to the international arrivals due to begin here on Monday. Bridget Rollason, ABC News, Melbourne.